over 30 years the name Drakeshead and Halstead have been synonymous in England and internationally with the work of retrievers and specifically Labrador training. In 1979, Sandra Halstead, with field trial champion Westhead Shot of Drakeshead, won the IGL Retriever Championship. And then in 1985, 86 and 87, 3 years on a trot, John Halstead, with field trial champion Breeze of Drakeshead, again won the IGL Retriever Championship. He then followed it up in 92 with field trial champion Rufflin's Pete of Drakeshead.
John, we're always looking at dogs and we're always thinking about how to train dogs. But one little part of the equation we sometimes forget is the person, the trainer. Now, you're a well-respected trainer. You're a legend in your own time, and that's not to kind of swell any heads, but you are. You really are well-known in that way.
Put away the dogs that you think you're not going to really want, because if you don't like them, you won't work with them too well. Pick the dogs you're going to like in it. He has got a little dog that he wants to build the motivation up, build a little bit of drive and interest up in. And you notice how he had that lead on to start with. One of the things John stresses all the time is the ability to read your dog, and it starts from the moment you get your puppy. Sandra is firing a gun, it's about 50 yards away, and she's throwing a dummy across there, which they enjoy fetching. A warm day, a shallow little, in this case, a mill stream, a shallow river, to take your dog and get them introduced to water.
John, one of the things that always interests me is, you know, problems start from the very, very beginning. And one of the things that you always want to do is to get a dog wanting to work with you, getting that kind of mental attentiveness, that attention. A lot of it comes from basic training, doesn't it? When you first start, a lot of people think basic training is boring, the heels and the sits and stays and stuff. But it's what you call the foundation again,
yes,
isn't it?
It is foundations, and it is boring in relation to the other work that you do, but it's imperative that you get it right.
Having complete obedience when they're close to you is essential if we're going to have any kind of obedience when they're far away from us.
Okay.
And a lot of this starts with heel work. Sit and stay. Foundation, really, of steadiness and, of course, obedience, and generating eye contact and all kinds of things. Sometimes when we then start to call them up, they're not often sure whether we want them or not. We have to encourage them. However, here's a little girl that is a little bit more difficult than that. Here's a little tip for the dog that's reluctant to sit and stay. It's not something you use every time, but you have to be creative in training. Show you a little interesting exercise here that happened. John had never thrown this ball inside a sock. She'd had tennis balls before, she'd had dummies before. Steadiness is an essential part of gun dog training. It's essential for safety, of course, when you're shooting in the field. You don't want your dog running out in front of the guns. Occasionally what happens is that we get a little dog that begins to start dropping the retrieve. You don't know why it happens. Someone's either play with other dogs, as John's mentioned. And the encouraged retrieve, that encouraged hold, takes time. It's not something you can do in minutes or even days. It might take a week to get that through to them. Good marking is essential to good gun dog work. And really, you want to start your marked retrieves in areas where the dog feels confident going to.
When you're doing the training, you're doing the steadiness with the dogs, that we've noticed, you're doing little marked retrieves, shortish marked retrieves, and in fact you're almost doing memory retrieves. Many times you take them back on the leash and then you walk them back to heel. How do you determine when to go to longer marked retrieves, and how do you determine when to go into blind retrieves?
The part of your dog in you, he's got to say to you, well, you are sending me in the right direction, I believe you. Blind retrieve. John has had these little dogs sitting on the whistle while they've been on the leash, sitting on the whistle as they come into him, but never sitting on the whistle at a distance. Once we've got our dogs stopping on the whistle, We've then got to be able to give it directions. Want to go back, want to go left, want to go right, and of course want to come in. If we can send our dog left, right, and back, we can basically get it to anywhere we want to, almost in squares. But to teach them left and right, we want to help them again. We want to guide them.
So we've learned the basics. We're ready now to go on to things like cold game. But this is more advanced stuff.
Yes.
Ready for getting ready for the field.
Yes.
And that we're doing in our next video, I believe.
Yes, that's right. Hopefully what you've seen on this video will carry us through to the next one. It'll be interesting to see what dogs we've got on the next one, because if they haven't come up to scratch, they might not be here.
I'll tell you what, I've seen some cracking dogs, John, and I've enjoyed every minute. It's been wonderful. I'm looking forward to the next one.
Go on. Go on.